Hello again, and welcome back to the card mart. Now, if you've seen my last video, this is done that receipt now at the end of that one, this one, yeah, something like that. I got the idea from watching Card Tricks. I've seen him do a move for a peak, as he classed it, I just sat down and I thought, and this came into my head, and I thought, and I tried it, and it worked, so I'm showing you. Yeah, I'll do like a tutorial version if you don't mind. Yeah, I don't want to perform my own trick that I haven't practiced. Right, what I'm going to do is riffle down the corner of the packet, and you can tell me to stop anytime you like, and we'll show you what card you come to when I show you the card. Right, so I'm going to turn my head so I don't see the card, because that's cheating. So turn my head and you say stop about there. So you want that one? You sure? Can you remember it? Yeah, okay. So you're thinking on a card now. Well, you're not thinking on a card, you're remembering a card. Now, if I just give the packet a bit of a cut like that, and then I'll give the packet a bit of a shuffle, just like this. Right. I didn't tell you what I've just done there, did I? Did you get onto that? No. Well, I'll give you a little tutorial on parts anyway. So at this point, you go, your card, look, bang. And they're going, how the hell? And you go, well, that's even better. Look, if I get your card and do that and put it underneath my hand. And while they're looking at your hand, you just drop your hand to your side, you know, as you casually would do. And when you got it to your side, all you're doing is the turn over. So you're turning their card face up on the bottom, right? And then you pull your hand back out again. As you go, look, and it's gone. Then you can cut the packet and go, wham, like that. Wham, dead loud. And might get them to jump. And you go, with magic, it's gone from there, and look, and then you can spread through the packet, and there's one facing down card somewhere in the middle, which when they turn over is their card. Do you like that? I did. When I thought of that, sitting there, I thought, that's good, that I've got to show someone, so I'm showing yous, yeah. Right, the bits I didn't go over, I'll do a very quick run through. Make sure your cards are sprung. So you got a little bend in them, yeah, right? Then when you flip them through the cards and they say stop, what you're going to do is really bend on that card. Six of clubs. And when it closes, it'll leave a break. And you just turn the packet around in your hand so you can see the break at the back. And then you can cut to it and you cut on their card to the bottom of the packet like that. And then you turn on the packet and you're glimpsing their card on the bottom so you know what it is in case something goes wrong. At least you know what it is, you can change it to something else. You just got their card to the top and you go, why shuffling? I've just got your card to go, well, hey, up there. And they're going to be amazed at that straight away. They're going to think that's the end of the trick. Until you turn it back over and go, watch, and you do a table palm, you know, where you don't do nothing, you just want one of them. And you keep their card on the top. Drop your hand to your side. You all know the little turnover where you're just pushing the card against your body. Turning the card over so it's the other way, bring your hand back out, go wah, way, whum, voila, and the gobs are definitely going to drop, aren't they? There we go. It's just something a bit crazy that came out of my little tiny mind. I hope it's out of my mind. If you've seen that somewhere else, please let me know. I'm made up with that one. Anyway, thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you again soon.